Okay, so good afternoon, class. Again, so this is a lesson 5 of Ecotourism Destination. Okay, so at the end of this lesson, students must be able to explain the different Philippine ecotourism destination and then describe the different ecotourism activities in each destination and discuss the natural resource management. All right, so here, we're going to discuss the different activities of the different key ecotourism sites here in the country, which is based on the National Ecotourism Strategy. Okay, which is based on the National Ecotourism Strategy, which is written last 2002, by those ecotourism technical working group, under ng DENR. And the Department of Tourism. Okay, so we all know that our country is composed of 7,641 islands. And the Philippines, known as the Pearl of the Orient Sea. So, in Tagalog, Perlas ng Silanganan. Right? So, and it is considered as the second largest archipelago after Indonesia. When you talk about archipelago, what does it mean, class? Any idea? What is an archipelago? Oh, any idea? What is an archipelago? Oh, do you have any idea when you talk about archipelago? Our country is an archipelagic country. So what do you mean by archipelago? Anyone here? Do you have any idea?
A group of islands, sir.
Okay, that is a group of islands. Okay, and of course, our country, it has 7,641 islands, but before it has 7,107 islands, diba? But some of the German allocentric, they were still discovered, and then the government sector, they're still discovering some of the hidden islands here. So that's why naging from 7,107, nag-increase into 7,641 islands. So, napangalawa tayo after Indonesia. Okay? Because the Indonesia is considered as the largest archipelago in the world with 17,000 islands. Grabe, no? But tayo 7,641 islands. But kahit 7,641 islands, we are very rich in the different natural resources here. Both flora and fauna, different topographies, water forms and land forms, and other resources, which is a best for an tourism product, no? Or pwede rin i-develop ng government or the LGUs, no? To become a tourism product. Okay, and of course, the Philippines is part of the Coral Triangle. Pag sinabi mong Coral Triangle, class, kasama niya dyan yung Borneo, Papua New Guinea, Malaysia, Indonesia, Solomon Island, and what do you call this? The Solomon Islands and Timor-Leste or the East Timor. So, there are, ang tawag sa Coral Triangle. Because that Coral Triangle, marami doong mga coral reefs or different species, hundreds of species of coral reefs that found in that coral triangle, okay? Na napapaligiran ng mga island na ito or island country na ito, okay? So that's why that coral triangle is a most diverse marine habitat of the tropic kasi located siya sa tropical area, okay? Tropical area yan. Pag sinabi mong tropical area, malapit yan sa equator. Kaya tinatag na tropical area kasi doon nakatutok yung recall this yung araw mas tutok, di ba? Pag equator mas tutok yung araw, kaya ganun. That is a coral triangle. Marami doong mga coral reefs na napapalibutan ng mga different island countries like the Philippines, one of that. So, and then those beautiful reefs, most of them are found in Sulu. Kaya that's why in, if you remember the South Sulu Sea, which is yung malapit sa Cagayan Sil, Palawan, yung Tubata Harip, the famous Tubata Harip. And then in between Sulu and Sulawesi Sea, na sa Malaysia and then the Sulu of the Philippines, yan yung home ng 580, no, of the world's 793 species building corals. Kasi sa buong mundo, meron pong 793 species of coral reefs. But matatagpuan nito 580, no, sa Sulu, sa Pilipinas, which is in Sulu and Sulawesi. Tapos sa ano naman, sa Great Barrier Reef, meron pong 300, over 300. Pero that is a largest coral, ano, atolls naman. Largest atolls ang Great Barrier Reef, which is located in Queensland, Australia. And of course, famous naman in Caribbean. Okay? 50, no? 50 in Caribbean islands. Okay? So kaya that's why ang Caribbean is famous for its cruise destination. And because it is good for a great destination for divers, okay? And of course, the Philippines is also habitat for 1,200 variety of reef fish. Aside from that, dito rin matatagpuan ang pinakamalaking isda. Actually, pinakamaliit dito din. The world's largest fish and the world's smallest fish here. The world's smallest fish is Pandaka pygmaea in Lake Buhi. While the largest fish, which is the whale shark, no, the gentle whale shark or butanding ng Dunsol Sorsogon. Naintindihan po ba? Question.
Wala po, sir. No, sir.
All right. And then of course, since our country it is a natural resource base. So meaning it has a potential for ecotourism resources. Ecotourism. Maraming pwedeng maging ecotourism activity. Kasi nga, marami tayo, may mga wetland tayo dito, like El Pipichea. Meron tayong mga volcanoes. Ang dami nating mga volcanoes here, especially if you want to visit Camiguin, there are 7 volcanoes there. Mga rugged cliffs, craggy seascape, like sa Peña Blanca, and sa may, Olango Island. And then meron din tayo mga serene lakes, like mga lake na magaganda yung tanawin, which is the best example in Lake Cebu, which is surrounded by woodlands, no? So those are harboring a rich variety of plants and animals. So kumbaga, maganda ang kanilang magandang balancing ng ecosystem nila. Okay? And then in the forest fields and mountains, about 500 species of birds naman. No, 500 have been recorded and 172 are found only in this island in the Philippines. No, 500 species of bird around the world, but 172 found here. So that's why the Philippines rank in the world second in Asia next to Indonesia na marami pong mga endemic animals. Pag sinabi mong endemic, doon lang matatagpuan, walang kapareho. Walang kaparehong species dito lang. That is endemic. Among plant-rich countries in the world, the Philippines ranks 25th in the world and 8th in Asia. Kapag fauna naman ang pinag-uusapan. Pag fauna. Naintindihan? Ha? Any more question?
Wala po.
Alright, so according to Conservation International, the Philippines is both a mega diverse country and one of the world's highest priority hotspots for the conservation of nature. So that's why matindi rin ang support sa atin ng IUCN or the International Union for Conservation of Nature, because our country has a different protected area. Okay, marami tayong ecotourism spot here, and of course we are very rich in flora and fauna as well as different natural resources. So that's why they are concerned in protecting our ecotourism site. So that's why may IUCN tayo with the collaboration with the DENR, the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. Okay? And then, of course, aside sa pagiging natural resources, of course, those natural attractions were belong or already belong in the UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Those are natural heritage, if you remember, mga natural heritage. So ano ba yung mga natural heritage natin? Meron tayong Mount Hamigitan, meron tayong Puerto Princesa Subterranean River Natural Park, meron tayong Tubataha Reef. Okay, those are UNESCO World Heritage Sites. And some of them also are listed in the ASEAN Heritage Site. ASEAN Heritage. Okay? And of course, another one, those natural attractions are biosphere reserve and then a transboundary park like yung Tawi-Tawi. No? Tawi-Tawi. Yung Turtle Island po sa Tawi-Tawi. Yung transboundary park na yung within the Malaysia and other protected areas. So those key sites identified, no, pinag-aralan ito ng mga technical working group or ecotourism technical working group, no. That's why it is part of the National Ecotourism Strategy, which is done last 2001, and then na-publish noong 2002 because that year it was the year of ecotourism. So it started yan. Remember, it was started during the time of Secretary Gemma Cruz Araneta, 1998, and it is natapos during the time of Richard Gordon. Okay, may question po ba?
Wala po, sir.
Okay, so if you have no questions, no? So let's proceed to the summary of forests, mountains, and volcano attractions. So doon tayo, no? So of course, our country, there are different, ang dami natin mga volcano because situated tayo on the Pacific Rim of Fire. Okay? Of course, we have most intense of forests, mountains, and volcanic attractions. Napaka-unique po. At of course, those are maganda din yung view. Okay? So nagiging enticing, no? Enticing sa mga mountain climbers or sa mga trekkers. Okay, so what are those volcanoes? Actually, Mount Apo, bakit sinama ko ang Mount Apo? Ang Mount Apo kasi class, okay, it is considered as dormant volcano pero hindi pa ito active. No, dormant volcano ibig sabihin there will be a possibility in the future na itong mountain na ito, but due to dahil sa init ng magkaroon ng init yan sa ilalim ng lupa, may possible po magbuo ng crater yan at maging cause ng sumabog. So may possible pong ganyan. That is inoconsider ito ng PBOX na dormant volcano. But it is located between Cotabato, kasi North Cotabato eh. Cotabato na ngayon yan. And then Davao. Okay? Davao. So this mountain, it is considered as the grandfather of all Philippine mountains. And this is the favorite site for mountain climbers and trekkers here in the country. It has 2,952 meter high, and located in the eastern Mindanao. And the hectare, it has 72,113 hectares. So what do you think are the activities here? Ano ba yung pwedeng maging activities dito sa Mount Apo? Anyone class? Can you give one? Anyone? Ano yung mga possible activities dito?
Climbing.
Okay, mountain climbing. Ano pa? Anyone? Ano pa class? Yes, Miss Balangge, can you give one?
Po, sir.
Ha?
Ziplining.
Ziplining. Mount Apo, ziplining. Okay, if you want to develop this Mount Apo, okay lang. Sige, lagyan natin ng ziplining. If you want to develop, ha? Okay, how about the others? What are the other activities na pwedeng i-offer dito sa Mount Apo?
Hiking, sir.
Hiking? Yes, Yubal, you want to say
hiking,
something?
Sir.
Hiking then. Okay, another one, this mountain is very rich in flora and fauna. Bakit? Sinasabi daw dyan daw ay makakita din ng mga Philippine eagle. May mga ilang species of tarsier. And there are 272 species of birds of which 40% are endemic, no? Ay doon lang matatagpuan, ibig sabihin endemic, doon lang matatagpuan sa Mount Apo. And of course, it has 6 different indigenous people not found in Mount Apo. These are the Manobo, Bagobo, Ubo, Atam,
Kilagan and taga Kaolo people. So the famous two are the Manobo and the Bagobo are yun yung pinakakilalang-kilalang indigenous people na patatagpuan sa Mount Apo. Okay? Okay, so this is also favorite for, by the way, last time I was remembering that this Mount Apo, they were close. Okay, sinarado na muna because sa daming ng mountain climbers and trekkers para maiwasan din yung pagsira. Kailangan muna ang i-minimize. No, bawasan na muna, kumbaga itigil mo na yung pag itigil mo na yung summit. Okay, para po mag-refreshing yung ano, yung mountain. Any more question? To refresh, no? Question class about the Mount Apo.
Hola, sir.
Okay, the Bohol chocolate hills. So, the chocolate hills it is located, no? In Bohol, the Bohol Chocolate Hills. So, syempre, located in Bohol, the capital is Tagbilaran. Okay, this chocolate hills is composed of 1,268 hills. Yun yung conical shape, ha? Conical shape ang tawag doon. Pero if you want to know or if you want to identify the 1,776 hills, kasi yun hindi perfect shape, pero ano siya, limestone naman. Okay, so it has 1,776 hills. Okay, and this they call this these chocolate hills, it's situated in 6 municipalities. Okay, situated ito into 6 municipalities. So ang tawag doon sa 6 municipalities na yon, yung kilala yan sa Sagbayan, Batuan, and Carmen. No, sulat natin, no? Sagbayan, Batuan, and Carmen. Wait lang. Sagbayan, Batuan, and Carmen. 6 yan eh. So, sa Sagbayan, ano? Sagbayan, Batuan, and Carmen. Which is famous in Carmen Bohol, no? And then, yung kanyang light brown, na lesser concentration of the hills located sa Sibilar, Sierra Bulyones, and Valencia. Bulyones and Valencia. Okay, naiintindihan po ba? A question? May question class? Wala. Okay. So, another one, of course, famous ang Bohol sa Tarsier, which is in Tarsier Pond, Tarsier Farm, and it is the smallest primate in the world. Okay? Okay, iba po yung primate sa monkey. Ang monkey, iba po yun, ha? Primate sa other species po yun, okay? So, the capital is Carlito Sirigta. Okay, and then the chocolate hills, yun, so pwede kayong mag-ano dyan, photography, hiking, ano pa, Lobok River cruising or river cruising in Lobok River. So meron doon raft na festival style siya, festival, and nagtatanggap ng mga bisita. So pwede, sa tour package po talagang sinasama yon. Mostly kapag may tour sa Bohol, yun yung river cruising sa Lubok, no? River cruising sa Lubok, which is business by the River Deep Floating Resto. And then with the help of the community, so doon kapag sumakay ka doon, aharas i-serenade kayo habang kumakain, serenading habang kumakain, and then nag-ano yun, babiyahe. And then pag nakapunta na sa pinaka destination, may pupuntahan kayo doon, mamimit niyo yung mga seniors na nag-yuyukulele. Okay? And then, yun. And then, aside from that, meron din Loway River, river cruising. Loway. So, that is another river. And then, as I said, Loway River, may mamimit kayo doon mga indigenous people na kilala. Actually, mga Ato yun. Mga Ato indigenous people. Okay? Yung mga indigenous people ng Bohol. Okay, next, Camiguin. Camiguin and Bukidnon, these are the two provinces in northern Mindanao. The capital of Camiguin is Mambahao. And what's the capital of Bukidnon, class? What's the capital of Bukidnon? Anyone? That is Malaybalay City. So of course, Camiguin, it is the home of the seven volcano, or known, also known as Isla del Fuego. The famous volcano there is Mount Hibok-Hibok, and also the Camiguin is famous for the different attractions such as the White Island, the Sunken Cemetery, and then kilala din sa mga falls, ano pa ba, sa mga springs, and of course, famous siya sa festival na Lanzones Festival because ito yung nag-isa sa mga resources ng Camiguin. Okay, and then when you talk about Cagayan de Oro, it's Bukidnon. Bukidnon, famous naman siya for its Bukidnon Forest, Canopy Walkway, and River. And of course, kilala dito yung Mount Kitanglad na kinukonsider ng ilang mountaineers na second tallest mountain in the world. Mga mountaineers ang nagsabi nun. They are declaring that. I'm not declaring, but those mountaineers, they were declaring that the Kitanglad is the second and highest than Pulag. Than Pulag, no? Ayun. And then the Bukidnon, it is a famous for its Del Monte pineapple plantation. That's why the Bukidnon, it is the pineapple capital of the Philippines. Okay? A question. Question, class.
Sir.
Okay, so again, when you talk about Bukidnon, meron din yung mga different tribes. Okay? And then those tribes, kapag nagkaroon sila ng Kaamulan Festival, it means gathering, doon sila nag-gather. Kasi yung Kaamulan na yan, yan yung founding, kung kailan daw founding date nung sa Bukidnon. Okay? Now, Mount Giting-Giting naman. Pag sinabi mo namang Mount Giting-Giting, also known as G2, it is considered tallest mountain in Romblon. So located siya sa Sibuyan Island. When they talk about Sibuyan Island, it's a crescent island. Okay, and then famous for its, yan, yung mga different flora and fauna, and then may mga different natural resources, but ang famous, it's Mount Giting-Giting. So it is covered with forest. At ito po ay pangarap ng mga mountain climbers. This is a dream for mountain climbers to reach the summit. But mahirap po yung summit dito. Kumbaga, parang may ano siya, merong isa, parang may sumpa yung mountain. Yun yung parang pagkakaalam ko. Okay, yung mountain na yun may parang ano siya, parang may sumpa. Pero may mga nakakaakyat. Pero may mga mountaineers na hindi pinagpapala, na hindi natatapos yung kanila summit. Yung iba hindi nakakabalik, no? That is a bad thing, no? So here so it has 6,752 feet or 2,058 meter high above sea level, and then the located the heart of the Sibuyan. So kilala kasi siya yung sa Knife Edge Trail, okay, the Mount Giting-Giting. Okay. And then marami ng mga failures na umakyat dyan, like yung mga UP Mountaineers, yan, isa sila sa mga talagang gustong-gusto tong akitin ng mga mountaineers talaga. Pero may mga ilan nagtagumpay pero may mga ilan na hindi. Okay? Next one. Kasi nga mahirap yung kanyang summit, talagang delikado yung mountain din. Okay, Natarik. Another one, the island of Sibuyan Island, it is accessible by boat from Manila North Harbor from the port of Batangas City. Or pwede rin by plane. So by riding any airline such as Cebu going to Tablas Airport in Tablas Island. Naintindihan po ba? Question, class.
Wala po.
Alright. Okay, then the Mount Isarog naman, it is located in Kamsur. In southern Luzon. Okay, actually, the Mount Isarogate is also considered as the dormant volcano, but it is famous for its bird watching because it is a sanctuary for a bird or any important bird area. So, by the way, it's one of the key conservation sites, no? It has 10,112 hectares, no? And then, of course, kilala din ito dahil sa kanyang largest tropical rainforest. Okay, located ito in the Bicol Peninsula. And now, itong mountain na ito ay gustong-gusto din akitin ng mga mountain climbers and mga hikers, no, to experience the summit in Mount Isarog. Okay, but this, ano, meron siyang crater and it's also a volcano, dormant volcano. Then Canlaon, located in Canlaon City, Negros Occidental. So, of course, this Mount Canlaon Natural Park, no, in Negros Occidental, it has 24,500 no hectares, no, with forest, yeah, may mga forest, and it is considered the highest peak in Central Philippines, which is in Western Visayas, okay? And then so the eruption or the eruption record nito recorded noong 1992. And of course, it is under the care of the Protected Area Management Board. No, Protected Area Management Board. So, pinapangalagaan nito, kumbaga, to avoid accidents here in Mount Canlaon, nililimit lang nila yung number of summit trekkers. Okay? And talagang nasa pangangalaga ito ng Protected Area Management Board because this is a protected area under natural park. And then the Mount Kitanglad, so as I said, the Mount Kitanglad is a catchment area for Cagayan, Tagaloan, and Pulanguri rivers. So may Cagayan River din sa south, which is located in Cagayan de Oro. So yun, and of course, this mountain or Mount Kitanglad, vital role siya in regulating the supply of drinking water and crop irrigation to the whole Bukidnon province. So dito po nakukuha yung supply ng drinking water nila and then of course irrigation sa mga taniman. Okay, another one, when talk about Mount Kitanglad, as I said earlier, this is the second highest mountain according to those mountaineers, no? It is taller than Pulag. Okay? And then there are different indigenous people, and those indigenous people they will participate sila kapag merong Kaamulan festival. Okay, those are Talaandi, Gigaonon, and Bukidnon tribes. Okay, by the way, this Kitanglad also rich siya sa flora and fauna but famous siya sa Philippine eagle. May question about Kitanglad? May question? Okay, next one is Mount Makiling. Okay, Mount Makiling, famous siya because of its legendary myth na si Maria Makiling, no? Kinikilala daw si Maria Makiling diyan. Kumbaga siya daw yung nangangalaga ng Mount Makiling, okay? And it is located between the Santo Tomas to Los Baños, Laguna. Santo Tomas to Los Baños. By the way, it has impressive forest on its upper slopes, no? And then there's an important watershed and contains natural springs. So that's why kilala po ang Los Baños diyan. Okay? All right. Okay, so here, this is a natural laboratory, no, of the students of or and the professor of the UP Los Baños. Okay, and then of course, Los Baños kilala talaga yan sa mga hot springs. By the way, trivia, the Los Baños, Laguna, it is considered as yung ano yan, yung town na ano na yung hilig, may hilig gravity. May hilig gravity. Okay. Another one, famous for its, yeah, pwede rin mag-mountain climbing dyan and trekking. Mount Mayon, okay, Mount Mayon, it is located in Albay. Okay? Actually, hindi naman siya perfect cone na perfect cone. Near perfect cone, ibig sabihin. 2,300 meter high. And of course, there are different, ano na, many times nang, ano to, nag-erupted. At hanggang ngayon, binabantayan pa rin ng P-Box. Okay? And then, it is a famous, popular destination for day trips and overnight climbing expeditions. So, that is good for mountain climbers and for trekkers. And then, class, saan ang pinakamagandang view ng Mount Mayon? Ha? Saan ang pinakamagandang, ano, view ng, anong town sa Albay, ang pinakamagandang view, the best view of the Mount Mayon? Anyone?
Daraga po.
Indaraga, yes, very good. Indaraga because... kaya nga that's why it's called Daragang Magayon. Kaya Daraga. Doon talaga ang pinakamagandang view. Okay? And it is Kagsawa Ruins. Another one, the Northern Sierra Madre Natural Park. Actually, it is located in the northeast coast, no? Northeast coast of the Luzon. And then famous for its Sierra Madre mountain range. And it is considered as the largest protected area here in the Philippines. So there are, so since this is a largest protected area, there are different activities na pwedeng pong i-apply here in Sierra Madre Natural Park. Okay? So of course, pinapangalagaan po ito, especially the DENR and then the Protected Area Management Board. Ang daming nangangalaga diyan because it is an important protected area, no? Another one, it is also rich in different species of flora and fauna. And sinasabi din, meron din dito ang eagle. Okay? And then, the trek, nagsisimula ito in Palanan. Ang Palanan is in Isabela. Palanan could be combined with wilderness and coastal activity. So that's why current security constraints need to be overcome and private sector operators engage in enterprise in order to make any significant conservation inroads by providing benefits to local communities in the park. Okay, so of course, maraming nag-i-engage dito, nangangalaga mga different operators, especially the private sectors, nagkakaroon ng investments here para mapangalagaan pa yung Sierra Madre. Okay. Mount Pinatubo naman, it is famous for its eruption last June 15, 1991. So kilalang-kilala, pinaka-famous volcanic eruption sa buong Pilipinas because yung lahar niya nag-flow hanggang umabot ito ng ano, umabot pa ng Taiwan. Okay? It has since become an attraction to visitors located conveniently close to Manila. Okay, by the way, since naging ano to disaster destination, so yung from the ano, 'di ba, sumabog yung bulkan na yan. So naging ano na, naging isang attraction na, lalo na yung lahar area doon, yung lahar area, nagkaroon na doon ng mga four-wheel drive. And then you will meet also those Itas or mga Itas people, especially in Capas, Tarlac. Okay? Ayan. So, these are the activity, lahar four-wheel drive, and then the trekking in Mount Pinatubo. And then the Mount Pulag, it is the mountain of the gods because if you're going to reach the summit, no, you will see yung pinaka-cloud, ang daming mga clouds niya. That's why tinatawag siyang the mountain of the gods. So, it is considered the second highest mountain in the Philippines, no, between the Nueva Vizcaya and Benguet. So, the Mount Pulag National Park covers 11,500 hectares and attracts thousands of visitors due to the location at malapit lang siya, 50 kilometers from Baguio City. But ang dami na rin mga ano dyan, umaakyat. There are thousands of visitors, so that's why kinuklos din nila yung Pulag para magkaroon ng recovering. Kasi yung ibang mga ano dyan, yung mga ang issue dyan, environmental issues, yung pagtatapon ng basura doon sa mountain. Tapos, ano pa, nasunog pa dahil may nagdala ng kalan. Yun yung naging issue. That's why kaya pinasara muna. Okay? And then, of course, the peoples or tribal people there ay yung tinatag ng kalangguyan. No? These are the dominant tribes of Mount Pulag. Other tribes include Ibaloy and Kankanay. significant feature, natural features. Ano-ano po ba yung mga natural features ng Matatagpuan? Meron dyan dwarf bamboo, meron ding mga extinct, meron ding mga musang or cloud rat. Okay, meron ding mga lambong o yung tinatawag na bamboo shoots. And then, mga pandan. Okay? Any more question? About Mount Pulag. Question? So, this is good for mountain climbing and trekking. And okay, Taal Volcano, this is considered as the famous eruption last January. Remember that? January? Last year, January. I was remembering that. Okay, but before this small volcano here, ito yung pagkakakilala nyo dati sa Taal Volcano. But nung hindi pa sumabog, ito, nalaman nyo na ito pala yung Taal Volcano. Ito, this is Bininti ang malaki. Okay, so famous siya yung panoramic view niya, kitang-kita sa Tagaytay. Okay? But now, inaano to, still watch and binabantayan ng P-Box kasi nga, may possible na sumabog ulit. Okay? So, ito 60 kilometers from Manila. By the way, if you want going to reach that Taal, pwedeng sa ano kayo, sa Talisay. So, sa Talisay, Batangas, sakay kayo ng boat to reach that Taal Volcano. And then, meron dyan mga horseback riding, hiking, and so on. Summary of coastal and marine attractions. Are you still there? Class?
Yes, sir. Yes, po, sir.
Okay, very good. So, of course, the summary of coastal and marine attractions. So, there are many coastals and marine attractions here in the Philippines. And those are world class, no? And it has a potential to provide crucial ecotourism positioning for the country. So some destination already well developed, whilst in other promotion, protection, and access remain constrained. So okay, so here, ano ba yung mga famous coastal and marine attraction under ecotourism site? So famous po ang Apo Island. The Apo Island, it is located in Negros Oriental. Okay, that's why it is called the Apo Island and Negros Oriental Marine Conservation Park. So, so it is this island po, it is may mga nangangalaga diyan. There's a community there na nangangalaga po or nagma-manage po ng islands na 'yan. So this island lies off the coast of Southeast Asia, Southeast Negros Oriental, with beautiful coral gardens, a rock climbing wall, and fishing village. Okay? So that's why kilalang-kilala to sa activity na rock climbing din, diving, hindi masyadong diving, fishing, and snorkeling. Ayan. There are different species of marine animals, no, here. And of course, that is also considered as a marine protected area or MPAs. Okay? And then of course, the Apo Reef Natural Park, that's the reef itself. No, it is considered the largest atoll type reef na tinalo pa. It is larger than Tubataha Reef. Okay, it's sprawling across 34 square kilometer. Okay, and it has a 375 species of fish, and then may bird life including the endangered Nicobar pigeon and a range of endangered plant species. By the way, hindi po kilala ang Apo Reef sa pagiging diving destination. So this is just a natural park famous for its different species of bird and of course isda. Okay, and then of course, pwede din naman mag-snorkeling diyan or of course, pwede kayong mag-isda. Fishing is one of the fishing activity. Bohol, again, let's proceed to Bohol, famous for its Balikasag Island. Ang Balikasag po, ito yung tinatawag na diving destination here in Bohol. Okay, because of this island is ringed by a reef that drops away with impressive submarine cliffs as deep as 50 meter. So that's why they want marami pong bumibisita dito sa Balikasag. Okay, and then that is island for diving, but if you want to watch the dolphins and then you want to see also the manta rays and the whales, so just visit the Pamilakan Islands. And the Pamilican Islands is 23 kilometers east of Balikasag. Okay, so anong mga activity? Pwede kayo mag-dolphin watching, may whale watching, and then other activities na related po sa water, no? Except diving and surfing. Wala pong ano dyan. More on fishing. Medyo ano lang, island ano lang. Yung diving, kakonti lang. Okay, this is the family, this is the dolphin heaven, no? Of this area. Near in the Pamilacan Island. And then Coron Island naman, it is located in northern Palawan. It has 71 square kilometer of hills, forests, and lakes. So kilalang kilala po dyan yung mga Tagbanwa people kasi yung lake dyan ay tinatawag na Kabugaw, no? And this Kabugaw, it is reserved for the Tagbanwa, and that's why strictly off-limits lang ang mga visitors dyan. Okay? Because pinapangamba din baka masira. Okay, Coron is highly valued for its diving, sea kayaking, rock climbing, and opportunities for island hopping. So kilala din yan sa for highland hopping activities. And of course, may rock climbing din because it is a, may mga ano yan, yan no? Yung cliff. And then, yan, yung hills niya. Pwede dyan. And then the other one, sea kayaking. And of course, favorite one is diving. One of the, ano yan, favorite ng mga divers. By the way, let's proceed to the Dornsol Sorsogon. Okay, in Dornsol Sorsogon, kilalang kilala naman ang Rhicodon typhus. Yun yung scientific name ng Butanding. Okay, Butanding, it is under the care of World Wildlife Fund. World Wildlife Fund. By the way, ang mga LGUs ng Dornsol, tinutulungan nila yung taga Oslob Cebu kasi yung mga taga Oslob naman yan yung ano yung mga may maliliit na yung mga Butanding smaller than Indonsol Butanding. Okay, and then ayan, this is a Butanding interaction, yun yung activity. Okay, yun nga lang ang naging issue diyan, yung mga Butanding diyan nasasanay pinapakain ng mga mangingisda. Pero dapat hindi po ganun kasi ang normal na kinakain niyan ay plankton. Plankton ang kinakain ng mga Butanding. Mga gentle po yan. Catered in Dornsol. So yan ang activity. No, interacting with the Butanding. El Nido, Northern Palawan naman, eto naman. So kilalang kilala to sa kanyang limestone cliff. Limestone cliff rising from the oceans. And then meron yung mga hidden lagoons or mga hidden lakes or hidden sea ang tawag na kailangan po pag magaling ka lumangoy, marireach mo yung hidden lagoon kasi although may magaguide sa'yo, no? Pag langoy mo yan, gaganong ka sa ilalim, pinakailalim yan, tapos lulusot ka doon para makalusot ka doon sa hidden lagoon or yung hidden sea, no? Kailangan magaling ka bumalik, ha? Kasi hindi ka makakabaluwi. Doon ka lang sa hidden lagoon. So yun yung kilalang ilala dyan sa El Nido. By the way, it is under the management of El Nido Resort because this El Nido Resort, they have a partnership with the airline specialists such as Sky Sunlight Air and then the Air Sweep. They have a partnership with those boutique airlines, no, para po sa pang for the ecotourism development especially here in El Nido in located in Northern Palawan. Are you still there? Are you all right? Just me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, po.
All right. So let's continue, no? Siargao Island naman, located dito sa Siargao del Norte and it is famous for its surfing destination, no? Surfing destination. So that's why, pero hindi lang yung kilala sa surfing, meron dyan mga dugong or sikaw, meron din yung mga flying foxes at meron din yung, sometimes may tarsier din, guro na dumarating din mga tarsier dyan. And may mga flying lemur na tinatawag na kagwang. Kagwang ang tawag doon. And it is a natural highlights in Siargao. Actually, this is may mga resorts doon, resort. And then yun ang kanyang pinaka famous activity is the surfing talaga. surfing. So now, there are many travel publications and mga different travel publications na they are declaring Siargao Islands one of the best island in the world or considers the best island here in the Philippines and best island in Asia and in the world, the Siargao Island. So, nagsimula lang kasi yan sa isang film. At nung nakita na tuloy-tuloy na yung mga tao, nagpuntahan na doon, nagkaroon ng curiosity. At tagal-tagal lang kilala ang Siargao Island. Ngayon, marami nang gustong umaten or bumisita sa magandang isla na ito. Okay, in Siargao del Norte. Then the Tanyon Strait, ang Tanyon Strait po, ito yung kipot na tinatawag sa Tagalog, kipot. Ito yung strait, ito yung bit in between Negros Oriental and Cebu. So if you notice in the mapa po ng between the Western and Central Visayas, mapapansin niyo yung Negros Oriental. Negros Oriental is part of Central Visayas, no? Meron doon tinatag na Tanyon Strait. Tanyon Strait na yan, may mga different species of ano diyan. May mga different species of what do you call this? Marine animals, no? So the famous attractions there, it's the dolphin watching tours, dolphin watching na which is arranged by the city of Baez, yung office of the mayor tourism operations guaranteeing dolphins throughout the year. So yun yung pinagmamalaki ng Baez. By the way, it is also a community-based protection and it is worked by the Silliman University, the first Protestant university here in the country, especially in Dumaguete. So ngayon, this island offers diving and beach recreation in a pristine environment with a strong domestic market base. So yun yung activity, dolphin watching ang pinaka-famous diyan sa Tanyon Strait. Yan. Another one, the Turtle Island Wildlife Sanctuary. This is a transboundary na malapit na po sa Malaysia. So this wildlife sanctuary is the only remaining major nesting ground of turtle rookery in all Southeast Asia. So kumbaga, itong island na ito may mga ano diyan pinapjaan yung maraming mga turtle dyan, inaalagaan yung mga pawikan or turtle. That is a turtle island. So malapit na ito sa Malaysia. That's why the government of Malaysia and the Republic of the Philippines have executive and award-winning because they have a bilateral agreement to protect and conserve what was called the TIPA. Yung TIPA na yun, yun yung Turtle Island Heritage Protected Area. But on the Malaysian side, no, yung mga Malaysian side ecotourists, they can see the wonder and all this of the turtles laying their eggs. Makikita lang. But from the Philippines, access generally considered unsafe due to the political upheavals in Western Mindanao and Sulawesi. Yan, these Turtle Islands. And ito po yung Transboundary Park. Actually, the famous island here na kung saan located yung Turtle Islands in Baguan. Understood, class? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the Tubataha Reef Natural Park, it is located in Cagayan Silio, Palawan. So in Cagayan Silio, no, it is a also remote atoll reef system, but in contrast to Upper Reef, Tubataha attracts a significant number of divers during May to July season. So actually, malapit nito sa Puerto Princesa, it has 200 kilometers from the city capital. Okay? So ito, the first inscribed UNESCO World Heritage Site here in the country. It was inscribed in 1993 and famous for its marine life. That's why favorite ito puntahan ng mga divers. No? At malaki po yung atlas niya pero mas malaki yung Apo Reef. By the way, last time nagkaroon din ng ano diyan ng mga different issues but still under yan ng pangangalaga ng Philippine National Coast Guard or the Philippine Coast Guard. Okay, let's proceed to the summary of lake, river and wetland attractions. So kilalang kilala po ang LP Pichea, the Las Piñas Parañaque Critical Habitat and Ecotourism Areas. Yan lang, located lang po dyan sa may between Parañaque, Las Piñas Parañaque, dyan sa may Rojas Boulevard. Nakitang-kita nyo dyan, mayroong daanan dyan, pailalim. Tapos ang famous diyan sa ano LP Pichea, mga mangroves, meron siyang mud flats, tsaka yung mga ang daming mga migratory birds, almost around 5,000 migratory birds. So that's why may ano diyan bird watching, it's a bird watching and bird photography destination. So that's why under ito ng control ng DENR. Okay? So if want to reach this wetland, so of course anong reason mo bakit mo bibisitahin? So kailangan meron kang coastal magco-coastal cleanup ka and bird watching and mangrove planting. Because there are 8 species of mangrove there, bakawan. Yung bakawan na yun, ano ba yung pakinabang ng bakawan? Class, ano ba yung pang ano ba yung importansya ng bakawan? Anyone? Anyone class? Ano yung importance ng ano ng bakawan? Anyone? So it acts as filter, no? It performs mangrove, it performs a vital integrity, no, by acting as a filter of garbage that comes from the land. So siya yung nagiging nag-a-act as filter. Kasi yung mga basura na ano niya na pi-filter niyan, hindi po nagtutuloy doon sa pinaka-bay talaga. Okay? So yun yung ano ng yun yung tulong ng mangroves. Okay, next, LP Pichea. So this is declared as critical habitat for migratory birds that found only between Las Piñas and Parañaque. And then the Agusan Marsh. Okay, actually yung mga ganyang area po, mga marshland po, ano po 'yan, delikado po 'yan because meron po yung mga different reptiles and crocodile. Ayan. Yun po. Pero pwede naman mag-boating diyan, pero it is considered as ecotourism destination because ano to eh, balance yung ecosystem doon at diyan po nahuli ang pinaka largest crocodile in the world. No, no, during that time it was Lolong, the largest captive freshwater crocodile here. Yun yung history si Lolong. Si Lolong, nung nahuli si Lolong, of course, dinala ito sa Bunawan Eco Park. And then, nung dinala sa Bunawan Eco Park doon, gumanda ang tourism na sa Bunawan Eco Park because ang pinaka-main attraction doon si Lolong. But nung yun, due to the death of Lolong, ayun, bumagsak ang turismo ng Bunawan. Naintindihan po ba? Bunawan Eco Park sa may Agusan del Norte. Anyone, any more question? Do you have a question, class?
Wala po.
Wala po, sir.
Wala po.
Alright. Next one, Lake Danao. So, ang Lake Danao naman po, this is famous for its picnic place, no? Which is surrounding po ito ng mga forest and then that lake. No, actually, this is the home of the different wildlife species po. Located ito sa Ormoc, Leyte. Ito po yun, no? Popular ito sa mga gustong mag-recreate at magtanggal ng stress. Ayan. Ito yung pinakamagandang activity dyan, yung picnic within the lake. Yan. Picnic kayo dyan within the lake. No? And it is located sa Ormoc, Leyte. So, aside from ano, pwede kayo mag-boating dyan, katulad yan. Pwede kayo mag-kayaking dyan and so on. Naintindihan po ba?
Yes, sir.
Olango Island naman, ang Olango Island, it is located ito sa east coast ng Mactan Island. Okay? So, of course, it established by those nag-donate dyan para ma-establish ito. At mapaganda po itong Olango Island. So, that's why meron po doon tinatag na Olango Bird and Seascapes Tour. Ayan, yung Seascapes Tour. Kumbaga may ano yan, parang nilalakaran doon para ma-reach mo yung Olango Island. And then, this Olango Island, famous siya sa mga different migratory birds. Yan yung habitat ng migratory birds. And then, also a village, may village life doon, mga community doon, and then of course it is also in an MPA MPA or marine protected area. So famous dito yung visiting village, no, or to have a cultural immersion. Aside from that, yung bird watching that is in Olango Island under yan ng OBST, Olango Bird Seascape Tour. Yan. Another one, let's proceed to the summary of cave attractions. No? Of course, cave attractions here, marami po tayong mga cave, especially in Peña Blanca, Cagayan, especially in Cagayan, that is a true Spanlancor's paradise. No? And then the Palawan, and then in Samar. Okay? Another, ito, yung Peña Blanca Protected Landscape and Seascape, ila lang kilala po dyan yung Calao Cave. So the Calao Cave, it has three pronunciation, Calao, Calao, or Calao. Okay, and famous siya sa mga bad flight, no? Sa kanilang may, kasi dyan sa Peña Blanca, marami ang cave system, almost 200 cave system. That's why it is a caving capital of the Philippines. Okay, and then, yan, mayroon dyan bad cave, kasi may experience may mga lumilipad na mga paniki. Okay, pero ang kilalang-kilala naman sa Calao Cave, by the way, meron din tour guide dyan, the famous tour guide na nangangalaga ng Calao Cave, si Andoy. And then, meron dyan yung, ano, yung chapel. And then, also, sinasabi po na ang Calao Cave, dyan nagsimula ang mga Calao Man, the first cradle of civilization. Dyan ang una yung, ano, dyan daw talaga, natalo po yung Tabon Man ng Tabon Cave, na located sa Barangay Panitian ng Quezon, Palawan. Okay, another one, Puerto Princesa Subterranean River Natural Park. So this is already a second, no, second longest underwater cave system. Okay, and then the famous so boating and spelunking, it is the famous activity there. So if you want to visit this Puerto Princesa Subterranean River Natural Park, so of course, visit Puerto Princesa City and then go to the Sabang Beach, ride a boat, and then may dadaanan nyo po yan, yung island na yan kung saan located po si Puerto Princesa. Kahit, by the way, ang tawag sa mountain na yan ay St. Paul Mountain and the St. Paul River. Okay, tapos pagpasok doon sa island na yon, may mga ma-encounter kayo mga flora and fauna, especially the monitor lizards and then mga monkey. Then yan, sa pagpasok nyo dyan, may makikita kayo dyan yung parang lagoon, ayan, yung river. And then sasakay kayo ng boat and then yan, you're going to experience the different karst formation or yan, yung mga formation sa loob ng mga stalagmites and stalactites. Mga unique formation yan, no? And of course, sa pinaka-loob-loob niya, may mga crystal cave because it was discovered by those German allocentric tourists. So, Oton Cave naman, ito kilalang-kilala to sa May Samar because of this one of the first national park in Asia. And then, meron tong natural stone bridge feature and cave system and attracts the domestic market. Marami pong gustong pumunta dito dahil nga, ang ganda nung kanyang formation din ng stalagmites and stalactites. Talagang maraming bumibisita dito sa Sohoton Cave. Ayan, like something like that. Meron po, ganyan po ipagpunta dyan. So, sasakay ka ng boat para ma-reach mo tong cave na ito. Another one, punta tayo sa natural-based cultural attractions naman. The summary. Kilalang kilala po ang Batanes. Ang Batanes naman, it is considered as the smallest province in the Philippines. Zero crime rate. Because ang mga people dyan ay talaga namang mga honest person. That's why meron sila dyan, honesty cafe. Okay? Honest kasi mga ibatan dyan. Ibatan, those are people who are living in Batanes. Famous, ang Batanes, it has three major islands. Namely, Bataan, Sabtang, Itbayat. So if you want to reach that island, just ride an available flight in Skyjet or Airsweep, and then sa Basco Batanes, especially doon yun sa Bataan. Okay, pero ang kilalang-kilala dyan yung Itbayat and the Sabtang. Okay, if you want to reach the other islands, just ride a Paloa. Paloa is the mode of transportation there. And then famous for its ruins of Songsong, the ghost barangay there, the Bayan Rolling Hill, the Batanes Lighthouse, Marlboro Hills, and many more. They are different. It is a unique destination, no? So you should visit this province. Okay? It is under Cagayan Valley region. Okay? So by the way, also diyan din yung pinaka northernmost isles kasi kitang-kita na yan sa kitang-kita na yung Taiwan diyan in the afternoon, especially in Waiame Isle. Waiame Isle, that's the northernmost island. Okay? So dati, if you want to reach Batanes, pupunta ka muna ng Tugigaraw bago ka makapunta ng Batanes. Ngayon hindi, may mga direct flight na from Manila. Any more question? Any more question? Sa Sabtang naman, pagpunta mo na Sabtang, maganda din ang Sabtang. Tapos ang mga tricycle doon, yung parang pagkagawa nila, yung gawa sa cabinet, yung mga parang gawa sa kahoy ng cabinet, yung mga tricycle doon, tricycle. And then the Ipugao Rice Terraces, the Ipugao Rice Terraces located in Ipugao, the capital, it's Lagawe. The famous for its Batad Banawe Rice Terraces and considered as the stairways of the sky and eight wonders of the world because during the time of ancient world, kilalang-kilala yung mga Statue of Zeus Olympia, Colossus of Rhodes, the Mausoleum of Halicarnassus, and many more, yung seven wonders of ancient world, pang-eight kasi ito because it was created by the Ipugaos 2,000 years or it was built, no? Kinurb nila yung mountain, no? And then ginawa nilang taniman or ginawa nilang hagdan-hagdan. Yung hagdan-hagdan na yan, ang tawag doon sa level or local term yan ay payo. No? Payo ang tawag doon. Okay? Payo. Ano yun? Payo ang tawag doon. Ay, hindi. Payo. Ang payo. Okay? By the way, if want to reach, maraming mga rice terraces hindi lang sa ano ah, hindi lang Batad Banawe but also may Mayoyao, Hapao at meron din po sa ibang ano, ibang probinsya like in Mountain Province. Pero yung mga rice terraces. So yun talaga yung pinaka ano, kinabubuhay ng mga taga Ipugao. Okay? And then mga Ipugao pa pag na-meet yung mga magagaling mag-English. So talagang lahat ng mga products nila it is made of rice. Okay? Another one, most visitors arrive on a North Luzon package which includes Sagada and Baguio. Now, sinasama na nila ang Ipugao. Maraming mabibisita kapag bumisita sa Cordillera Administrative Region. And the last one, Lake Cebu, of course, famous for its scenic beauty and cultural attractions. Okay? Mamimit dito, mga makikita mo dito, yung mga tibuli because tibuli are good sa skill nila paggawa na, sa good sila sa pagwi-weaving and paggawa ng mga brasswares. So yan, pwede kayong diyan mag boating then you will see those tibuli okay in Lake Cebu. Napaka-unique ng destination na yan. Ang ganda ng destination niya ng Lake Cebu. Okay, so any more question about the different ecotourism destination class? May questions pa po ba? Wala na kayong question.
Wala po.